So you've probably seen some of our lessons working with students. Maybe you've wondered how it actually works, because it's kind of weird. We've got the cameras all around. We've got three coaches and one student, which is like nobody ever does that. So we wanted to explain exactly how this happens and what the point is. Like, what's the purpose to having three coaches? So we have basically three main roles. We have the bus driver, the person who's kind of in charge of leading the process with the student and doing the explanations, which is what Kevin is doing right now. We have the production person with the iPad, whose job is to help assist the bus driver and also capture the video of each of the drills, each of the different movements that we have the student go through. That way it frees up the person who's leading to just watch the student and just focus on the student. And then what I'm doing today is recording the action plan. By the time we're done with a student and working with them for 2 days, we usually have a 12, 13, 14, 15 page document that explains every drill, every explanation, every analogy that we used, all the different reminders that were helpful, so that when our students go home, they can set up a ball machine, do the same drills the same way, focusing on the same things, and they can essentially recreate the process that we went through here. The reason why all the video and production is critical is because, in addition to the action plan and having that resource, tangible resource to go home with, we provide the student with the whole experience that they went through on video with all the different camera angles, so that they can watch themselves learn and watch themselves go through the learning process when they get back home. And we have a lot of students report back and tell us that it's like learning from a totally different perspective. And so their understanding deepens dramatically when they see themselves from that third person perspective go through the whole process. All of a sudden they're like, oh, I see now why they asked me to tweak this and why they had me go back a step and work on the easier thing for a little bit before we move forwards, because they actually see themselves do the whole thing. So it's another deeper layer of awareness and understanding. The person who's in charge is obviously important because he's kind of doing the direct like guidance of the student. But what's really critical in that role that a lot of people miss, and what's a core part of our philosophy and our process, is pinpointing and picking the one part of each stroke that's most important, that's most fundamental and foundational, that everything else has to be built on top of in order to be successful. Because Megan is doing the video and because I'm doing the recording, Kevin is totally freed up to just focus on that one thing, which is the one thing with the student, to help them make progress as fast as possible on that critical element. The reason why Megan's role today on this stroke with the iPad is so critical is because we do not make any decisions, we don't offer any suggestions, we don't alter any techniques or change any strokes without first seeing exactly what's happening in slow motion video. So Megan's role of just capturing everything so that Kevin can be like, oh, let's take a look at that one. Or if the student's like, I don't know if I did that right or not, we're constantly able to immediately get the feedback of what really happened, what didn't happen, so that we can make informed decisions as coaches, and also so that the student is confident that they're moving in the right direction and they're not just doing random stuff like just because. They can see right there on the screen instantly that they're heading in the right direction. The reason why the recording of the action plan is so critical is so that when the student goes home, I mean, Noel is here from Boston, so we're in Milwaukee, so he's not gonna have all three of us standing there with the iPad and giving him feedback when he goes back home this weekend and he wants to work on his back end. So recording this in real time is critical so that he could step off the plane, go to a tennis court, follow the exact same process immediately. And so we like to record it as it's happening so that it's as accurate as possible, it's as detailed as possible, and it's also delivered basically instantly. So the student can go home and immediately go through the very same process and keep things moving forward in the right direction. And so the essential tennis, whatever you want to call it, process or methodology or philosophy, is one of, first of all, like I talked about before, picking the most important element that needs to be changed so everything else on top of it can be improved. And then from there, it's a matter of managing the amount of challenge or difficulty for the student so that they can do the new thing effectively. And that means starting with just slow, smooth shadow swings, no ball at all. And then from there, taking baby step after baby step after baby step of layering just a little bit more challenge, then a little bit more challenge, and guiding them through until they get to the point where they can actually do the new thing with a ball in kind of a real life situation. And by following that process, within a couple hours, we see dramatic changes in technique on a stroke. Whereas most lessons, you'll spend 15 or 20 minutes on your forehand, 15, 20 minutes on your backhand. We'll spend 2 hours on one stroke and see a huge before and after change by going through that process. So we're just about at the end of our morning session. This is day one. These coaching sessions go 2 days with 3 hours in the morning and then 2 hours in the afternoon. And so we've been working through this backhand progression for about 2 hours now, and students doing fantastic. We're probably getting ready to kind of wrap this up because we're going to transition to something else. And usually over the course of 2 days, we get to about 4 or 5 different strokes and work through this whole process of revealing what needs to be focused on and then showing them how to work on it and giving them the plan for 4 or 5 different strokes depending on the student. So the people who come here to do this are really passionate about making it to the next level. They don't want anything sugarcoated. They want to know the truth. They're not looking for a surface level, like little tip or like tweak to what they're already doing. They want something fundamentally different and better. And that's what we designed this process for. That's where we're always trying to navigate towards and improve it for those people like our student today that isn't satisfied with what he has. He wants something completely different. And we love showing tennis players how to achieve that and send them home with all the resources they need to make it happen. Nice job.
Thank you.
Yeah.
This is good.
Nice work.